creating this is a good Egyptian example. That's why this initiative has different ambassadors, those who are marketing this initiative. And now I will give the opportunity for them to introduce themselves. I'm honored to be an ambassador to Decent Life Initiative to support our people in rural areas. Egyptian village is the origin of the Egypt. That's why all people in rural areas, every village, everywhere, east, west, north, south, it is a must to get decent housing units, decent schools, education, clean water, electricity, health centers, education, roads. Decent Life Initiative is not just a construction of roads, it is a hope for us all. The impossible is possible now. The difficult things are reality now. Each citizen has to enjoy decent life of all rights. I am very pleased to be an ambassador in Decent Life Initiative. Our people in villages and rural areas deserve decent life. The village is the origin, it is the root. We are growing all out of it. We are cooperating with Decent Life in different four sectors, education, health, and childhood protection. We are very pleased to cooperate with Decent Life Initiative, and we will continue doing so. We will support Decent Life continuously. I'm very honored and I'm very pleased to be an ambassador to Decent Life Initiative. I'm very honored to be an ambassador to Decent Life Initiative. Good infrastructure, clean water, sanitary, roads, youth clubs. All people deserve to live in decently. They must find culture centers, youth club. From now on, all people will be under spot and we will help them all. I'm very pleased to be an ambassador to Decent Life. I'm very pleased to be an ambassador to Decent Life Initiative. Today, we are supporting rural areas. Decent Life Initiative is an opportunity to restore our life in rural areas. Decent Life has a good economic aspect. It drives the economy in these villages. Egypt needs us all. I'm very honored to be part of Decent Life Initiative to serve our people in rural areas, and this is the least we can do for our country. It is an honor to my colleagues, the businessmen, to help create job opportunities in rural areas. Those people deserve decent life with good capacity, good opportunities. And the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is the best who is caring for those people. This is a great achievement. We support the President. I'm very honored to be an ambassador for this initiative, and I wish decent life for all Egyptians. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi initiative, Decent Life, will change the life of 50 million people. It is their right to enjoy decent housing, water, roads, health centers, schools. They all deserve decent life. I'm very pleased to be part of Decent Life, to support our people in rural areas. I'm very honored to be an ambassador to Decent Life Initiative. Egyptian village is our cornerstone, backbone. The President is racing to provide decent life for all Egyptians, and we all will do so. I'm very pleased to be part of Decent Life Initiative. This initiative is aiming at relieving the vulnerable people. I'm very honored to be part of this initiative. This is a great initiative. We waited long time for this initiative. I'm very pleased to be part of this initiative. This is one of the most important national initiatives in our country. It is the right of each village throughout the whole country to enjoy decent life. Health centers, culture centers. Very honored to be an ambassador to decent life. Very pleased and very honored, and I raise my head up that I'm ambassador to decent life. I'm very honored to be part of the Decent Life Initiative. I'm very honored to be ambassador to decent life, to support our people in rural areas. I'm very honored to be part of this initiative, to support our people in rural areas, to achieve our main objective, to have a modern country. I'm very honored to be part of the Decent Life Initiative. This is an honor for me to be an ambassador. I'm very honored to support our people in rural areas. To support our people in rural areas. I'm very honored to be part of this initiative. Very honored to be part of this initiative. I'm very honored and pleased to be part of this initiative. And myself, I'm very honored. I am very honored to participate simply in this initiative. This initiative that would restore the position of our villages, their position and their life, the village in our culture is our country yard. We have occasion in our country yard. This is the plant, the family, the peace and security in these areas, the kindness of the people there. Even if you are getting old, you will feel that your roots are there. This is the backbone of us all. That's why the initiative to develop rural areas is not just a normal initiative. It is a personal issue for each one of us, as rural areas are our families, ourselves. That's why when we look around us, we are very pleased. We are developing the rural areas, and this is in a new record. Who imagined that hundreds of villages would be developed in very short period? The secret is that determination. Egypt had the intention and the determination. Long live Egypt, our great leader.
Oh.
Your Majesty, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, we tried tonight to present even a small part of the great effort exerted in decent life, struggling, addressing problems that lasted for a long time. Thousands and thousands of heroes participated in this initiative, hand in hand, officials, engineers, technicians, volunteers, and others. All are under one umbrella. They all are Egyptians, and they all deserve to be honored. And now I call President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi to come to the stage and to honor some of the good examples, those who participated in the national project Decent Life. Executives, Engineer Ruqayya Hamad Arabi Farghali from Aswan. She was the executive head of the Water and Sanitation Authority in Aswan, and she achieved high rates of achievements, and she solved all complaints and challenges she faced in times of implementation. Mr. Gabriel Fateh Abid Gabali from South Sinai, coordinator of Decent Life and Secretary General of the Youth in the Governorate, and he was graduated from the Presidential Leadership Program. He achieved the programs properly and greatly. Mr. Muhammad Rafat Abdul Aziz Kafr Al Sheikh, Governorate, and he is Assistant Governor to National Projects and the Facilities and the Coordinator of the Initiative in the Governorate. He was professional in dealing with the and achieving the plan and objectives of the initiative. Mr. Abdul Wahab Gabr Al-Hadari from Al-Gharbiya, Governorate, coordinator of the initiative and a member of the technical office of the governor. He was graduated from the Presidential Leadership Program. Mr. Muhammad Abdul Salam Hassan Abdul Nabi from Ismailiyah Governorate. He is the head of the local unit Kantara Sharq, and he is honored for the continuous following up of providing drinking water for people in the northern parts of Sinai and central areas of the canal. Mr. Rimon Safwat Shafiq Musa from Almenia Governorate. He is official in the governorate, one of the most efficient people to serve decent housing unit project. Engineer Abir Abdelrahman Mahdi from Armenia Governorate. She is the official of digitalization unit, the governor office, and she is the coordinator of the initiative in the governorate. Engineer Niveen, researcher of the governor office, and she is coordinating daily with different officials of the initiative in the governorate. Mr. Magdi Riyad Abdul Ghaffar Abu Shona, head of Al Shuhada local council. He participated hugely to count the state lands to be used in projects and followed up that greatly. Volunteers. Mr. Muhammad Ahmed Ismail Abu Ghresha, Mayor of Awlad Ali, Al Munsha'a District. He volunteered to listen to the needs of the citizens. He was coordinating between them and the government entities. Dr. Zainab Ali Salama Al-Fayoum volunteered in the initiative. She was graduated from the National Academy for Training. She is cooperative to monitor and follow up instructions accurately. Decent Life Coordinator, Mr. Muhammad Ali Gabri, Beni Suif, Governorate Coordinator, and graduated from the Presidential Leadership Program. One of the best coordinators to deal with the problems professionally, solving them by the least potential. And his mother is going to receive the a word on behalf of him. Dr. Ghada Khidewi Sayed, New Valley Governorate Coordinator of the initiative and graduated from the Presidential Leadership Program. She was efficient while dealing with the problems during the implementation, even if the governorate is big enough. Mr. Tariq Ahmed Ali Suhag, governorate, graduated from the presidential program, one of the best people, those who did their job properly. He was following up many villages, and he is the award is going to be given to Mr. Muhammad Tahir on behalf of him. And finally, special honor to the late Muhammad Hassan, member of the presidential program and Decent Life Initiative in Qalyubiya, one of the volunteers who were working sincerely Muhammad Hassan died due to COVID-19 in Al-Qalibiyya, and we are honoring him, and his brother is going to get the medal on behalf of him. And now the president is going to sign the document of the national project to develop the rural areas, the decent life. And now the statement of the President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, the President of the Republic. In the name of Allah, thank you very much. Thank you very much. However, allow me to thank you all to greet you all and to thank you all and to congratulate you all and happy Eid for all of you. This day is a good day. I will not commit myself to the statement, and I will tell you that in the past, when I was walking in areas that are poor enough, I was dreaming to change this reality. I said that before. And I was telling myself, if I have money, I will change that out of my pocket. $100 billion is enough or not? Some were telling me that you are dreaming. If you have these money, you are not going to do so. Listen to me carefully. That's why I got more than money. I got the blessing. The blessing. How can you change your country? How can you serve your people? How can you change the country? Will you be able to change? Will you be able to satisfy people? Will you be able to please people? I hope so. I hope we can do so together. I'm not going to be lengthy in this point specifically. Before giving my statement, it was necessary to thank and greet and appreciate the blessing of God over us all. Look around yourself that we are blessed by God. We are protected by God We were rescued by God. I thank God. In the name of Allah, Egyptian people, great people, dear attendees, I'm standing in front of you tonight in a moment, mixing the feeling of pleasure and honor, pleasure of being among representatives of different Egyptians, an honor of what we achieved consecutively and the great achievements we made together by Egyptian hands, and I can feel honor by achievements done by Egyptians. We heard Egyptians everywhere, different streets, expressing the will of Egyptian country to restore the country from those who were humiliating the country, using misconcepts, extremist ideologies, supported by the Egyptian army. I was honored to lead this army. I was honored to lead the army during these moments, critical moments in the history of our country. We were biased to the will of this people. We had great challenges due to our decision as people and state to restore the country out of those who were trading the country, trading the religion. We were determined to overcome these challenges and to succeed and win in these struggles. When I responded to your call, I was confident that Egyptians have great potential. I was quite sure with my team that we will be able to rescue the country based on our sincereness. I feared no one but Allah. I have no other objective but our country. I did my best to do so. I was confident that this people is brilliant enough and has unique personality. The Egyptian personality was inspired and proved for the whole world that it can do great things. And they didn't give up to the media or terrorism that was trying to destroy the country. There were great challenges, however, they weren't stronger than our will, our determination to overcome them and to secure our country, secure our future. We countered the terrorism in which we lost many of our soldiers in the Egyptian army and also police officers. We penetrated different economic crises that were accumulated throughout last decades. Economic reform program was targeting the Egyptian citizen. Egyptians tolerated the impact of this program on their daily life. They understood the main objective, which is to secure a better future for coming generations. We pledged to build our constitutional institutions. We formed the constitutional chambers. And we were racing to build our country maximize the capacity and the national project, mega project actually, where reflecting the Egyptian intention to build all Egyptians throughout the whole country have got the opportunities to get decent housing unit, and we developed the unsafe slum, modernize our road network, expand agriculture land until we reach out to this great project, the development of rural areas, decent life initiative. We try through this initiative to develop the standard of living for more than 4,000 villages. We are aiming at achieving sustainable development, improve the quality of life for 58 million citizens throughout the coming 3 years. The budget is 700 billion Egyptian pound. I declare tonight the launch of this promising project, and I pray to God to help us, and I'm confident that Egyptians, government and people will help us. And I believe this launch is a launch for new republic, the Egyptian Republic. Egyptian Republic, which is stable and which is based on the principle of a new modern democratic country that has comprehensive capacities military, economically, socially, and give the priority to citizenship, acceptance of others, achieve peace, stability, and development. We are looking forward to the achievement of political development based on the social justice principles and decency, humanity. We are seeking to build Egyptians comprehensively, whether for health, culture, and education. We believe that Egyptians are the treasure of this country. Egypt, the strong country, the modern country, the civil country, democratic country, will be a good place for Egyptians, reflect their expectations and represent their sacrifices. The great Egyptian people, this is to renew my promises and the pledges to launch our new republic that was born out of your revolution on 30th of June. We are determined to take steps forward. I renew my promises and the pledges, and to launch our new republic that was born out of your revolution on 30th of June. We are determined to work more, build more with our comprehensive potential to achieve economic and political development. We are going to find more common grounds among people of this country, provide all tools for young people to achieve better future for them and for their country. I express my deep appreciation to the Egyptian people for all efforts exerted, for all sacrifices that they offered to stand together, secured, safe, seeking development and construction. I thank the armed forces, Egyptian army, for what they offered and presented their sacrifices to secure this country and keep the resources of this country. And I also thank the policemen, police officers, for their role while countering the black terrorism. I thank every and each worker, every and each farmer, each and every scientist, and I thank especially Egyptian women. I thank greatly and especially Egyptian woman. She played an important role in our journey while facing these challenges. Ladies and gentlemen, Egypt is managing its foreign relation regionally and internationally based on fixed principles. Based on mutual respect, we prefer peace, respect international law. Egypt as well is owning the political tools and the military strength, economic strength that would enhance our determination and our willingness to protect our resources. To achieve peace and security regionally and internationally, the approach we adapted was based on practicing the maximum of self-restraint and rationalization of our practices and not to impact on the national security in the long run and short run. And let me tell you frankly, let me tell you sincerely, thank you. I can tell you sincerely, and I assure you that the Egyptian national security is a red line.
Thank you.
Any risk against the Egyptian national security is not acceptable. It is a red line and it can't be allowed.
إن ممارسة الحكمة
To be wise and to prefer peace does not mean by all means that it is allowed to touch the resources of this country. We will not allow anyone to affect these resources, and we have different options to maintain it. We decide accordingly and based on the conditions. Egyptian people, ladies and gentlemen, I keep my promises and pledges. I renew them from time to time. I will act as a sincere son of that country, not having any personal interest, would serve you, confident in your abilities, believe in your determination. I keep my promises for you, renew them from time to time. As a son of this country, I serve this country without any personal interest, and being sincere for this country, and believe in your determination. I pray to God to help us. All I give this statement, and I was telling you that dreams are not obsolete. To believe in your dreams is a way to make the present and the future. To believe in your dream will enable you to make the present and the future. And I have a big dream for my country, a great dream like you. My dream for this country is big and great like you. I have determination to achieve this dream like you as well. Let's be sincere in our dreams. Let's work for this country permanently and always. Long live Egypt, long live Egypt, long live Egypt. And peace be upon you all. Allow me. That was my statement. If you allow me. This issue is very important. The issue I'm going to speak about is very important. And I hope you all would be silent and listen to me. This is a very important issue. We are all concerned about it. Listen to me. Listen to me. All Egyptians are worried about it. And I told you before that your concern, your worry is legitimate. And let me speak to you quietly without any tension. Let me tell you the story. In brief, let me tell you that we were all dealing with these issues, all our issues, with rational ideology based on planning, and we are realistic, and we are not trying to maximize or let you dream of something which is unrealistic, or to try to make you sympathize with us in a fake way. Your concerns with regard to water, this is something legitimate. This is your right. This is a legitimate right. Let me tell you. Listen to me, as it is very important issue. This issue is very important. You asked me to lead the country. I pray to God to help me leading this country again. Your concern is legitimate. When we were speaking about this issue with Ethiopians, Sudanese people, we were willing to make Nile River is a river for partnership and welfare for us all. And we said that we are not willing to benefit alone from this. We repeatedly stated that, and we said that if, as you say, that this dam will be a source of development, you will generate electricity, we support you. We are willing to cooperate with you in anything that would help you develop the life of Ethiopians and Sudanese people, as well as Egyptian people. We said that, and that was our attitude, that was our approach. Let me tell you that we are confident in God and in ourselves. We are not believing in destruction. This is exceptional. Construction and development is the main source. We were telling that frequently, to share experience, to cooperate in power plant projects, electricity generation projects, industries. In Egypt, we have great potential that we will make them available for our brothers and sisters in Ethiopia and Sudan, and also for other African countries, on one condition: no one touches the river, Egyptian water. Why I'm saying that now? Just to simplify the matter, Egypt wasn't aiming at threatening or intervening in any other country issues. We were calling them to cooperate. As we said before, we agreed that you can generate power for Ethiopians. While assuring the Egyptian quota of water, it is simple. We got different responses. They said that we are ready, we are not going to affect on the water that goes to Egypt. We ask it for a law or any agreement, any binding agreement among the three countries with regard to the filling and operation of the dam. We took this approach, and we still doing so, and we went to the Security Council to include this issue in the international agenda. We are well prepared and we are planning for that long time ago. I can tell you some points, but others I can't. I can't tell you some other points and the preparedness we are doing in our country. We are making projects to save water, to save water in Egypt. The project which is saving water, which costed us 60 billion in Egypt, I hope within 2-3 years we will finalize this project. The treatment treatment stations that were established during last years and the ones that are going to be established in coming years, this is part of our efforts in this regard. We are doing every possible effort in this regard. We are telling them that you can live and we can live as well. Egypt is a big country. It's not appropriate for us to be worried or concerned. Let me tell you something. Listen to me. When I feel your concerns, I know that this is legitimate for you. But when I feel that it is overestimated, I can tell you that this is not correct. I swear by God. I have to be careful while telling you anything. I have to be careful and also I act carefully. The future of people and countries is not to be determined in that way. It requires great effort. In all past times, we didn't succeed. We succeeded as we are acting jointly, facing any challenge, if it is considered as a challenge. We are not going to succeed unless we are acting as one man. This is for all Egyptians and for all our brothers and sisters in Ethiopia and Sudan. Let's get a legally binding agreement that would achieve welfare for you and for us, and to live together in peace and security. This statement for whoever is concerned with stability, security, and development, regardless, or it is not a threat. I hope this concern would be balanced. It's not appropriate for us to be over concerned. Myself and the army must sacrifice ourselves first before any harm that would affect on that country. I'm not going to be lengthy. I swear by God that everything is going to be okay. We have different plans. We're doing our best. Do not worry. Live your life. Enjoy your life. I can tell you something that you are saying it frequently. Egyptians. It's not that easy. I'm not going to say it. It's not that easy. No. It's not appropriate. I can't. Do not overestimate.
كل سنة وانتم طيبين.
Happy Eid.
بطمنكم واطمئنوا بفضل الله.
Be assured.
كل الأمور ماشية.
Thanks to God. بشكل. Everything is okay.
بخير بسلام بأمان
وأرجو. And I hope.
مش هقول ما تسمعوش كلام حد.
That you are not going to listen to others, or I swear to God that I was sincere, honest with you. And I will keep myself in that way. Do not believe in every word you listen to. I'm not going to forget to tell you again that I pray to God. I thank God. I pray to God to help us. I pray to God to help us as happened before. Thanks God. Thanks God a lot. Thank you very much. And peace be upon you all.
السلام الوطن.
National anthem of the Arab Republic of Egypt.
حكاية في مصر فكر
بس تتشال على الراس والمصري يستاهل تبقى حياته كريمة إياك يا مصر في يوم تقلق ويا سيدي الناس بلدك هتفضل عاملة لك دايما قيمة اسكندرية دي ناس مليانة طيبة أصيط سوهاج وقنا دول بيخصوني القاهرة والجيزة جينا رحنا نسينا مطروح وكفر الشيخ ياخدوا